بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. In the name of Allah, the Most Beneficent, the Most Merciful. I testify that there is no true God worthy of worship except Allah, and that Muhammad is Allah's true slave and messenger. May Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam be upon the noble Prophet, the believers of his household, the believers of his family, and the companions and those who follow on their path until the day of resurrection. We reach the point where Shaykh al-Islam rahimahullah, this is class number 18, where Shaykh al-Islam rahimahullah said in his response to that question by the person who was seeking to know about the righteous deeds that he can benefit from, and he told him, وَأَمَّا وَصْفُ الْكُتُبِ وَالْمُصَنِّفِينَ فَقَدْ سَمِعَ مِنَّا فِي أَثْنَاءِ فَقَدْ سُمِعَ مِنَّا فِي أَثْنَاءِ الْمُذَاكَرَةِ مَا يَسَّرَهُ اللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ. As to that which you intend to know about the books that you may refer to, and the name of their authors who may have written concerning knowledge and ilm, then we came across some of that during the discussion which may have preceded the answer to your question. And then he said, وما في الكتب المصنفة المبوبة كتاب أنفع من صحيح محمد Ibn Ismail al-Bukhari. And in those authored books that are tabulated with titles and chapters, there isn't any book more beneficial than Sahih al-Bukhari, Sahih Muhammad bin Ismail al-Bukhari. And the complete name of Sahih al-Bukhari is الجامع الصحيح المسند من حديث رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وسننه وأيامه. The compiled authentic narrations from the reports of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام narrations, his sunan and his days. Shaykh al-Islam rahimahullah said in Majmu' al-Fatawa, volume 18, page 74, أَمَّا كُتُبُ الْحَدِيثِ الْمَعْرُوفَ مِثْلَ الْبُخَارِي وَمُسْلِمِ فَلَيْسَ تَحْتَ أَدِيمِ السَّمَاءِ كِتَابٌ أَصَحُّ مِنَ الْبُخَارِي وَمُسْلِمِ بَعْدَ الْقُرْآنِ. Concerning the books of hadith, the known books of hadith, like the Bukhari and Muslim, then under the sky, there isn't any book more authentic than that of Al-Bukhari and Muslim next to the Quran. And this great book the Ummah had accepted, and the scholars devoted a lot of time discussing its narrations and talking about its author and his methodology in putting forth this great work. And the greatest of all it may be in terms of the discussion and the studies on Al-Bukhari's book of hadith collection is Fathul Bari bi sharh Sahih Al-Bukhari by Al-Hafiz Ahmad bin Hajar Al-Asqalani rahimahullah rahmatan wasi'a. And he wrote an introduction to that in a volume, actually an introduction called Hadiyu Sari Muqaddimatu Fath al-Bari. And he wrote in that introduction a detailed discussion concerning Al-Bukhari's book, and he spoke highly about this Sahih. And it may be that the incitement which led Al-Bukhari rahimahullah to put this great effort in collecting these narrations from the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. It may be the incitement he received or he heard from his sheikh, Ishaq ibn Rahawi rahimahullah. And Al-Hafiz bin Hajar mentioned this, and he, Ibn Hajar, narrated his chain of narration to Ibrahim bin Ma'qal al-Nasafi, where he said that Abu Abdullah Muhammad bin Ismail al-Bukhari rahimahullah said, كنا عند إسحاق بن راهويه فقال لو جمعتم كتابا مختصرا لصحيح سنة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. We were with إسحاق بن راهويه when he said, if you would compile a book, concise book, collecting the صحيح of the Sunnah from the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. He said, that settled in my heart, and I began collecting the Al-Jami' al-Sahih. And Ibn Hajar rahimahullah said, he said, quote, وَرَوَيْنَا بِالْإِسْنَادِ الثَّابِتِ عَنْ مُحَمَّدِ بْنِ سُلَيْمَانَ بْنِ فَارِسِ قَالْ سَمِعْتُ الْبُخَارِيَّ يَقُولُ رأيت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وكأنني واقف بين يديه وبيدي مروحة أذب بها عنه فسألت بعض المعبرين فقال لي أنت تذب عنه الكذب فهو الذي حملني على إخراج الجامع الصحيح. الحافظ ابن حجر رحمه الله said, and we narrated with affirmed isnad, chain of narrators, to Muhammad bin Sulaiman bin Faris, who said, I heard Al-Bukhari rahimahullah saying, I saw the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as if standing before his hands, and there was in my hand a kind of fan, waving it at him. فسألت بعض المعبرين, I asked some of the interpreters of dreams, فقال لي, you will defend the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam against lying. This is the thing which incited me to work to compile this Al-Jami' al-Sahih. And from the known matters concerning his work is his precision in collection. And he said that I didn't write anything in this Sahih, no hadith, except that I took a ghusl before that, وَصَلَّيْتُ رَكْعَتَيْنِ, and I offered two rak'ah. Al-Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah is Abu Abdullah Muhammad bin Ismail bin Ibrahim bin al-Mughira bin Bardizbah al-Ja'fi. He was born on a Friday after Salat al-Jum'ah, thirteen of Shawwal, the year 194 after Hijra, in Bukhara. Ibn Hajar rahimahullah related that his warraq, meaning his copyist, narrated that he heard Muhammad bin Kharrash saying that he heard Uhayd ibn Hafs saying, دخلت على إسماعيل والد أبي عبد الله عند موته. I came visiting the father of إسماعيل, or the father of Imam Bukhari, his name is إسماعيل, أبي عبد الله على إسماعيل, his father, when he was dying. فقال, so his father said, لا أعلم من مالي درهما من حرام ولا درهما من شبهة. I don't know, I have earned nothing from my wealth through a way that is haram or through a doubtful way. And that it is also narrated that Muhammad bin Ismail, when he was young, he lost his sight. His mother in the dream saw Al-Khalil Ibrahim, Prophet Ibrahim, in the dream, and he told her, يا هذه قد رد الله على ابنك بصره بكثرة دعائك. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala returned the sight to your son due to your invocations, many invocations. Al-Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah said, ما اغتبت احدا قط منذ ان علمت ان الغيبة حرام. I never resorted to backbiting against anyone since I know that backbiting is unlawful. And it is known that even in his criticism of the narrators, he is very cautious as to the wording he uses. A few are the instances that he would say about a narrator, kadhab, liar, or a fabricator. Rather, he would say, kadhabahu fulan, such and such declared him as a liar. And his copyist narrated or said, whenever I traveled with him on a journey and we stayed together at one place, except that I would see him during the night, getting up from sleep almost 15 times during the night. Every time he lits a light, gets the narrations, mark, highlight then on them, and then puts his head back to sleep. قال قتيبة بن سعيد رحمه الله about Imam al-Bukhari. Imam al-Bukhari in his time is like Umar in the time of the companions. وقال الإمام أحمد رحمه الله ما أخرجت خراسان مثل محمد بن إسماعيل. Khorasan did not produce anyone the like of Muhammad bin Ismail. And Raja bin Raja al-Hafidh rahimahullah said, هو آية من آيات الله تمشي على الأرض. He is a sign of Allah's signs walking on the face of earth. وقال الحسين بن حريث rahimahullah, لا أعلم أني رأيت مثل محمد بن إسماعيل كأنه لم يخلق إلا للحديث. I've never seen like the like of Muhammad bin Ismail. It is as if he was not created except for the hadith. And Imam Muslim رحمه الله one time came to Al-Bukhari فقبل بين عيني, so he kissed him between his eyes, وقال دعني حتى أقبل رجليك, let me go and kiss your feet, يا أستاذ الأستاذين, your professor of the professors, وسيد المحدثين, and the leader of the محدثs, وطبيب الحديث في علله, and the doctor of hadith regarding its defects. And Ibn Hajar رحمه الله said, if I would open the door to continue writing about the praise of the A'imma concerning Al-Bukhari, then the pen would dry, for he is a sea without a shore. Many good dreams were seen for Al-Imam Al-Bukhari rahimahullah after his death. أن محمد بن حاتم وراق البخاري محمد بن حاتم the copyist of البخاري said رأيت البخاري في المنام I saw البخاري in the dream خلف النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم behind the prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام walking behind him فكلما رفع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قدمه anytime the prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم would lift his feet up during his walk وضع أبو عبد الله قدمه في ذلك الموضع except that أبو عبد الله meaning البخاري would put his feet in that same place. And Al-Farbari mentioned that رأيت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم I saw the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم في النوم in a dream فقال لي أين تريد where are you heading فقلت أريد محمد بن إسماعيل I am heading to محمد بن إسماعيل meaning البخاري فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أقرئه مني السلام relate my salam to him. وقال أبو زيد المروزي رحمه الله كنت نائما بين الركن المقام بين الركن والمقام I was sleeping between the ركن and the مقام in Mecca by the كعبة فرأيت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في المنام so I saw the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم in the dream فقال لي يا أبا زيد أو أبا زيد إلى متى تدرس كتاب الشافعي ولا تدرس كتابي how long you gonna continue studying the book of الشافعي and you don't study my book فقلت يا رسول الله وما كتابك I said O Messenger of Allah what is your kitab what is your book قال جامع محمد بن إسماعيل the compilation of محمد بن إسماعيل meaning البخاري قال الواحد قال عبد الواحد بن آدم الطواويسي رحمه الله رأيت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في النوم ومعه جماعة من أصحابه I saw the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم in a dream and with him a group of his companions وهو واقف في موضع he was standing in a place فسلمت عليه so I saluted him with salam and he returned the salam فرد علي السلام فقلت ما وقوفك هنا ما وقوفك هنا يا رسول الله why you are standing here O Messenger of Allah قال أنتظر محمد بن إسماعيل I am waiting for محمد بن إسماعيل meaning البخاري قال فلما كان بعد أيام بلغني موته فنظرت فإذا هو قد مات في الساعة التي رأيت فيها النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم few days passed and we heard the news of his death meaning الإمام البخاري then I just found that he died then I found that he died in the same hour in which I saw the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام بخاري's death رحمه الله قال ابن حجر رحمه الله that Ibn Uday رحمه الله said سمعت عبد القدوس بن عبد الجبار يقول I heard عبد القدوس بن عبد الجبار saying خرج البخاري إلى خرطنك the Bukhari left to a town from the towns of Samarkand its name is خرطنك and he had relatives there so he came visiting them قال فسمعته ليلة من الليالي so one of the nights I heard him saying after he finished the night prayer saying in his دعاء اللهم قد ضاقت علي الأرض بما رحبت فاقبضني إليك قال فما تم الشهر حتى قبضه الله he said oh Allah the earth vast as it is was straightened for me so take me to you the narrator said فما تم الشهر the month was not finished or completed except that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala before it was completed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took al-imam al-Bukhari and he died the night preceding the Saturday that night of Eid al-Fitr the year 256 after Hijrah he completed rahimahullah 62 years less 62 years less than 13 days. Then Sheikh Islam rahimahullah continued saying, لكن هو وحده لا يقوم بأصول العلم ولا يقوم بتمام المقصود للمتبحر في أبواب العلم إذ لابد من معرفة أحاديث أخر وكلام أهل الفقه وأهل العلم في الأمور التي يختص بعلمها بعض العلماء. But it is meaning صحيح البخاري alone is not sufficient to establish the foundations of knowledge, because the knowledge is diverse and branched, and it's not sufficient for the one who wants to get in depth in knowledge. It's inevitable that knowledge of other narrations is needed. Because Sahih al-Bukhari did not fully contain all that which is authentically related from the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, and therefore it's a must to check the other books of hadith as well, and also kalamu ahli al-fiqh, the words of the people of fiqh, so that the person combines both the fiqh and hadith understanding and narration. This is the correct manhaj. And also the one who seeks in-depth knowledge must also come to know each branch of knowledge through the scholars who focus their works on such branches, like the branches of hadith, the branches of knowledge about the Quran, the branches of knowledge of the Arabic and the like. This concludes this session from the concise admonition, and there remains one class inshallah ta'ala, and the concise admonition will be by the will of Allah completed. Walhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, wa sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.